Continuum 2025 has just been released, and with it comes four new transitions designed to elevate your workflow and extend the capabilities of what's possible within your NLE or preferred motion graphic software. In this video, we'll cover Smoke and Fog Dissolve, Smoke Wipe, Orbs, as well as Atmospheric Glow, and what you can do with transitions as a whole inside of Boris Effects Continuum. Let's get started. Okay, I'm here inside of Premiere Pro, and I have a sequence opened up with two clips where I'd like to add a transition between the outgoing and incoming shots. In this case, I'm going to head to my effects tab by pressing Shift-7, and let's do a search for one of the first new transitions inside of Continuum 2025, which is Smoke and Fog Dissolve, as well as there's a Smoke Wipe. I'm going to grab Smoke and Fog Dissolve and place it as a center edit point. And what this does is it uses a smoke-based texture along with a dissolve in order to cut from one clip to the next. Like all BCC Plus transitions inside of Continuum, if we select them and head to the effect controls, we can take a look at the effects editor. And you may be already used to presets that you can select. So there are several presets that use all of the parameters that you see here on the right-hand side, combined with the smoke texture in order to create the transition. But there's something else that we've added for this transition and a few of the effects now in Continuum, which are the actual sprites or textures that are used as part of the effect. So how they work is if I start playback, so let's just say that we selected the default preset, we can preview all of the default parameters, but then also see how they might mix with another sprite. So all of these sprite textures that I'm clicking between here, and you're going to see available for you here and also Smoke Wipe, we have the default parameters with a different texture. And the same would go for, let's just say if you chose the texture dip through black, it uses, if we look over here to the right-hand side under smoke, the static pulse smoke sprite. And if I start to click, all that gets switched, all the other parameters stay the same for this preset, the texture dip through black, but all that switches is the actual sprite. So we have a visual symbol for it. And you're also welcome just to choose from all of the sprites slash textures in the drop-down menu. So in this case, while it's being used to dissolve, and let's just compare that to Smoke Wipe and the difference of how it's going to reveal the incoming clip. So I'll apply this to head back to Premiere Pro, and let's go back to the Effects tab, where just above the Smoke and Fog Dissolve is the Smoke Wipe. And I'll just drag it to replace the previous effect. Go to the beginning of the sequence and then just make this full frame, where now we can see that we have the smoke texture actually acting as a wipe to reveal the incoming clip. But let's select this, head back to our effect controls, head inside of the effects editor. We can take a look at some of the presets. Some are much more textured and have very little softness when they do the reveal. So they almost act as grunge-based elements. And then others, which are much more subtle and have a much softer pattern, I'll choose the soft, large, static as the preset reveal. I'm going to stop playback and just move my playhead right over the middle of the transition here to take a good look at this in the viewer. And one really handy parameter under the smoke section is random seed. So you can use this to drive which parts of the image it first reveals earlier or later in the transition. All you have to do is just move your playhead there to kind of get a sense for what's being revealed first. Kind of like to see maybe some of his sunglasses here. And by increasing things such as the scale and the density, we could also reveal more of the incoming clip earlier in the start of the transition. So playing around with those smoke settings, not to mention we still also can experiment with all of the different smoke sprites until we find our desired outcome. is by just simply clicking on them and preserving all of those other parameters that we had access to earlier. And one thing to keep in mind is that once you have a transition you like, you can save it as a preset in the effects editor and then share this with someone in Premiere Pro or another application outside of the Adobe ecosystem that supports Continuum. Anytime that you'd like to save a preset, simply just click on this Create Custom Preset button. You'll be presented with a dialog box where you can add a name, tags, and a description. And once you do, this will then be saved inside our preset list and available for access here, not to mention as an XML file on your system. I'm just going to cancel out of here, press apply to go back into Premiere Pro, and let's just do a full screen playback of that end smoke wipe on the first example. Next in our new transition list, we have BCC plus Orbs Dissolve, and play back to you this little backward motion we have of these actors, followed by the incoming clip that we would like to cut to. I'll head to the effects tab, just clear my search results and type in Orbs. We'll find that Orbs Dissolve transition and apply it to the edit point in our timeline. And what we can see is a series of textured orbs, which all have separate speeds, are moving and mixed with a dissolve in order to make the reveal from the outgoing clip to the incoming clip. I'll head to the effects tab and let's go into the effects editor because there are a few other things that we can do with the orbs, and I'll just and see some of these presets. Some that are very interesting besides this individual orbs animation that you see here is also the ability to have the overall orbs pattern move from one side of the screen to another on either the X or Y axis. You can see these with a few of the drift presets. So right now, I'll just select the drift right to left, and you should see the orbs pattern starting here and with a revealing various parts of the pattern from right to left. And of course, we can switch that from left to right. And if you're ever looking to change the speed of this motion and what causes this, is under the orbs light source. So setting the source animation to just source won't have that orbs movement that we're seeing here. And if you're looking to adjust the speed of this start end source animation, simply just change the X values of source start and source end to be closer together. And that will slow down the movement of the reveal of the orbs pattern. Again, there are quite a few to choose from, all different stylistic looks. Some of them, like slow, small, and desaturated, also take the source clips and desaturate them at the height of the transition. And you can see those values just under here, under the color correction tab, where the saturation is set to negative 100 in this case. I'll just go back to the drift right to left based on the movement here, and just press apply to bring that into Premiere Pro, where we'll take a look at the final result moving between those two clips with the orbs pattern. Last but not least, we're going to take a look at atmospheric glow. And the atmospheric glow effect was introduced a few versions ago inside of Continuum. This works in the exact same way, but if you want to get in depth with all of the different controls, I suggest that you take a look at the previous video that I did. But atmospheric glow, one of the magical things is it combines smoke, orbs, glow, rays, all in this ultimate effect to give you maximum choice when it comes to dissolving with a glow effect. So let's go to the effects tab, clear the search results again, type in atmospheric, and I'll choose the glow dissolve under the transition category, where we can see by default, we have a glow mixed with a light rays pattern, some grain, as well as some orbs moving from the first clip to the second clip. Now, depending on your clip's luminance values, one thing that you're gonna wanna do is either go into the effects editor or work in your host and adjust the threshold amount to decide which bright pixels you want to be affected. In my effect controls, head to the effects editor. And here, let's go under glow. And if I start to play with the threshold, bringing that value down, more bright pixels are affected. If I bring it up, less are affected. Similar to the orbs effect, one thing with rays in the presets here is that they have that same source animation option where you can have rays animate from one side of the screen to the other, like in this preset, the rays left to right. I'm going to choose the orange strong vignette in this case, which mixes a orange glow, where I'll bring down the threshold so we can see its strength. Let me increase the radius, and let's twirl up this section just to see all of the other sections available for you here that you can mix, such as grain enabling that, and choosing from a colored grain pattern or just making that monochrome to add to that atmospheric glow look. Now, last but not least, with any transition, it is worth mentioning the on-screen controls here, which allow you to affect the easing in and easing out of your transition. Some transitions also have an easing mid value that you can take advantage of. If I go here to animation tuning here at the bottom and start adjusting, we can see the ease in adjustment here at the beginning and the ease out here at the end, followed by the ease mid if required. Definitely something worth playing with to change the feel of how you move from one clip to the other. I'll click apply, and then just like before, we're back inside of Premiere Pro. If you prefer not to go to the effects editor, keep in mind you can work directly here in the host and have access to all of those parameters that we've been adjusting over the last few examples. And there you have it, working with our four new transitions inside of Boris Effects Continuum 2025. For more tips and tricks like this, don't forget to subscribe. And there are several other videos covering the new features inside of Particle Illusion, not to mention our ML tools that you should definitely check out.